Oh, Nobel's there, but yeah. Anyway, that's a test again. Me coding unit tests. Very interesting. Let's start. So I have already copied one of the other tests I already did and some comments with all the codes. Now I have write the test for them. So let's start. Start segments, because I thought it would be a nice idea to have headings for each opcode and then doing the tests for all the possible things you could do. Copy my test infrastructure. Here's the ID. I did not copy it, but I do one test structure for at least that's the current ID. So, LQ test. And start by LDQ. From the old test infrastructure, I just leave it there. If I need it, or if I do different testing code for each of the opcodes, I will see later. So then we need to load something. Fine. So there are two values. This was for the Miss Love. Hi. I have a viewer. Wonderful. So I'm not talking to myself. That's nice. Okay. So these are the two test values from the set indexed tests. So I could see if the set index would shift into the second value. And then the last three values are the expected result, the bit mask for the flex, and the expected flex. So for LDQ, if we load this, there should be no flex set, I would say. So we have the here the manual item for LDQ, and it says that it will set N flag if it's negative, if bit 31 is set, and set flag if it is zero. We check with LDA because that is where it is coming from, and they are the same flags set. So this means if we load this, no flags should be set, but we are not the unset, set flag, unset. So now I need to remember which bit mask is which flag. And here's my handy function for that. So 80, so the highest bit is the N flag, and 2 is the set flag. So if we end with hexadecimal 82, we will mask out N and Z. So let's do this. 82, and with this value that we load, there should be neither of them set. So we expect that this will be. So next test will be the same, but now we load 0. And we expect 0, and the flags should be in this case because the zero flag should be set. And the last one would be loading a negative value. So we could just go FFFFFFF, but I like some pattern, so I go backwards FE A 98. And we expect the same. And we expect the flags to be 80 because the negative flag should be set. And can we have a combination with both negative and zero? No, we cannot, because zero is not negative. So that's the three tests we need for LDQ. And this would be these three tests for LDQ with base page addressing. A humming noise. Okay. Voice is very low. Let me see. I can go a bit up with and the humming noise. Good question. Where this comes from. I have a new part in my setup, which is a USB hub. Let me get this out. So now I connected the microphone directly to my laptop. So is the humming noise still there? Or is it gone? Gone. If it is gone, then my hub is bad. And it should be louder, my voice. I hope so. Humming noise could also be my laptop, because I'm still using it to encode. I have some new equipment, but I'm still working on the setup. So my desk is currently a big mess. I have bought a R10 Mini Pro. But yeah, I still don't have all the stuff I need to connect, all the things I want to connect. Okay, no noise. That's bad if this is really the hub. Yeah, but I have some other problems with the audio, especially with the audio. If, for example, I use my my display as a USB device. So the display has a SD card reader and a USB hub. And if I write to the SD card, I will hear noises in the speakers which are connected to the display. So, yeah. Okay, quite all right. So we go on with that. So now will be the next part, which is this with. Then we this. So now we need a D as opcode, and we will be addressing with long 16-bit address. How this is this called? Absolute addressing, I guess. And we will load the same values, but obviously the code must be different for our test. So essentially I can use the same test, I guess. I only need more space for the 16-bit value address I need to set, and I actually can use the same locations for both base page and 16-bit addressing, because I just need to set the base page to the most significant byte of the 16-bit address. So So I can write the values at the same locations and it should work. So, and the tests are essentially the same. So we don't need to change anything here. And then the next would be absolute. Check if it's called absolute. Absolute. Instruction sets. Sometimes I get less loud because I turn my head away from the microphone, and if I talk directly into it, it sounds different than if I talk 90 degrees away from it. So our instruction set. It is absolute base page. Yeah, I was right. So program, and now we need base h indirect set index. Oops, $MN, comma set. $MN, set. And it is B2. Okay. What do we have here? Oh, we need something that is just different. So I will use this value in the upper place, and then we need a test that shows us that set is here. Okay, normally I load the value here first. Okay, I need to think for better test for set index, because we want to test with, I don't know which we all want to test, but if the test should be for XEMU, and I notice that LGB has, he only has problems with the wraparound in the base page. Something like that. Don't remember for sure. Okay. So the question is, do I need more than the three tests? And do I need tests with set equals 0 and set equals something else? Would make sense to see if the set really works. Yeah, so we need both. Which means I would do more than three tests here. And oops, long. Okay, we need to make the message long. So, and then here we need some other way around. And here we need. If not, this is all. Shifted one. So, but I need to think of a way where this offset comes from. Where's my test program? This program is thoughts. Some bullshit value, then it LDQs 380, and then it LDQs 384. What put I put indoors. Okay, I put, oh, which test did I copy? I copied the wrong test. Copy. This one does what? Has three values. Ah, okay. One word. This is the set in one. Here the test is. Okay, it loads that to zero. Ah, we don't want to. Complicated test. Make the test program so that it works. So perhaps I also make different code snippets. This is just the assembler of encode of the assembler you see above. Perhaps I do different code snippets for each opcode. For now, perhaps I can condense them if for certain instructions. For example, I guess I can make one for those, perhaps also for BitQ, and one for those two, and one for the logical operation. And then perhaps one for all the shifting operation. Yeah, that might be possible. So those which use the same addressing mode can be cool. Don't need extra stuff. So now copy this one. But not for SDQ, I guess. Yeah, for LDQ. Then we load here this. And we don't really need to load something. Would need to load something for SDQ if we would test SDQ with the same. So we could. Then. Something base page. It used the real base, not top something. Yeah, but it does not matter. So the right thing would be not those, but to actually use the values. That value for the shifting. Start with five. Y F zero C this. So we need to know where in the bytecode the set is loaded, because then we can change it later to 2 so that we get the offset. Now, here the flag. Overflow flag, not really needed here because we don't check overflow flag, only check n and set. And that is here because we loaded 0 here. No, it's set because we loaded 0. All right, does not matter because LDQ will override it anyway. So then we need to do our opcode, which would be LDQ. Neck, neck, LDA. And first is load from a base page address. And then we need this load from a zero page, from a absolute address. So that 3 bytes here. So I put this one, our code, here is your overflow, then the 242s are the neck-neck, and now the opcode for our LDA has to follow. So in that case, standard, the first LDA I will. This one is a 5. Then the address has to follow. Can be 80. And then we need some placeholder, which does nothing. Which could be a knob, essentially. Or AOM called this process. Then we need to come to the place where we store the stuff. So we're storing to 0388. This is wrong in opcode. Check what PHP is. Pushes wrong processor. P08 the PHP, which pushes the status register to the stack. So then I save 038s on F, then I PLA store to 9 this, and then there's the RTS and good. Different addresses. Segment is a bit P. Not a comment. Comment. Nick. If I use a different zero page, then I would need to do a tab command. So what does tab do? Tab changes the base page. And then, because we are nice, we also do this back at the end so that we have a nice cleanup and test itself. Don't really want to do the CLI, I guess. I think I don't do the CLI. Okay. Fixed it also. Oh no. A, which is A9, what was it? 5B, right? B. So now we also shifted everything bytes back. 7, 8, 9. Line that way. So we shifted 3 back, so this is now on place position 12. And this is our test code. And we will have the zero page, the 30-bit addressing mode. So we also need to add something, some other placeholder front here. There's the C4. The C4. Okay. So we have the opcode, we have the TLC, we have the NACNAC, we have the LDA, we have 16 bits of addressing, and the rest don't need. So now we need to see which is our offset. It is simple, it is 13. Code. How long it is? Is it 10:30? Nine. 42 is enough. Only seem okay. This is was one thing, because in the last live stream there was 5 concurrent watchers, but I did not see anything in the chat or something. So currently I see So in the studio window I see nothing, no users, no watchers at all. But perhaps Mislav has left. I don't know. Could be. Mislav, are you still there? So we don't need. So now here we need. Thing. 0 and 1, right? 1 was the 32-bit thing. So we just also use. Good. Then I need thing I copy. So currently everything is done in the except some utility function. So now I want to have some test opcode, call it, and it will have I don't know. What will it have? Some parameters, obviously. Needs the code snippet. And code is what again? Unsigned char. Okay. Pointer code, and we need some number char steps the two flag for the messages, and we need tests. 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 Okay. Buffer some way at the offsets test to little hack. F then. Well, we do wild pokes into memory, so that's not recommended C, so I guess we can unrecommend. Okay. Good. This looks opcode. So what do we do for test? This. Terminate L copy. This tip. L copy. This is I'm searching for a L copy. It would. Yeah. Don't. Okay, there's not only a L copy with sound. Makes sense. But it is a character pointer. So essentially, stringlen code should give me the length, and then I add one because I want to copy to 0 byte. I guess this. Something is wrong with the intention. So then we need to first write some method. Yes. And we have the line. Okay. Turn. Oh, we don't turn anything. So don't parameter the line. Also good. There was one thing I was missing, is this. Look, there are the marbles. So first thing is to... Oh, we need aim for... Need some structure. Around test structure. As something like a name. The offset. Okay, we have a structure. Two and was it with type dev? Oh man, I don't remember. No, I saw your, did not saw your, see your comment. Yeah, it's All Saints Day. I know. So, be with your family for sure. thanks for dropping by. If you still hear me, I don't know. Okay. Type dev. I can't remember how type dev. So. Onto perhaps someone used type dev somewhere. Funny. And this might jog my memory. Yes, it does. Okay. Call this unit test because this is one. We call it opcode test. And then this is the opcode suit. Then we have here opcode test. Tests. So now we could use our opcode suite which then will have the offsets and LDQ and then it has that is now a good question. Do this to remember how initializers work. Don't remember. Death that I already know you, but what about perhaps it just again curly bracket. We just asked the compiler if it likes it. Then we opcode. Okay, so at this strikes react. Q of test. So, 50. Too many initializer. This makes it more happy. Ah, this makes it more happy. Wonderful. So, let's sample issue now. All right, wonderful. Our issue num is the issue. But as we are going through our issue, perhaps we make the issue. Also part of our struct. This is issue one. I rather love this. Okay. So now we need two things. We need to set the name, which will be suit name. And this you issue and set sup to 0 test read. Want to write some line. No, we don't really need to write this out. We only need the message for the end. This 0 stop. Each opcode starts with sub. Shoot. One, we don't want to start with 0. And then copy the code. Right, and then go through this. Test and check opcode 1, because if it's 0, then this was the last test. Then we need That's 388 to world speed. And this will be only speed. Okay. Now we need to write some stuff into our, and we need to modify our code snippet because there are these offsets and they tell us what to do. So essentially I need this because I have either the test with set clash 0 or the test with set clash equals to 2. So this is the least significant bit tells us this, and then with 2 it will be the 32 bit indirect offset, and with 0 inset, and this will be 32 bit indirect with set equals 2. So this is our opcode 2, and it's not really opcode 2, it's here, it's opcode mode. Yes. Yeah, mode code. So, and then I also want some flag set. Set. Wrong. Minus. String gets too long. But we can make it. Oh, this is not really long. Bounty character. So we don't need really. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Kill this. Does it compile? No, because No. Change code. So, what do we need to change? We need to change depending on our mode. Mode 0, we really do nothing. And then we also need to know what our addressing is. So, essentially, I need morph. Yeah. So one. Let's do some. Bit one would be zero page. Bit two would be absolute. It's 3 would be 16-bit indirect, and bit 4 would be 32-bit, and bit 7 is set to 2. Good work. And 0 would be no addressing, so for something like in QQ. Yeah, okay, sounds all right for now. So now we need to check this. So if mode and one, then let's be verbose first and then make it nice. So this would be zero page addressing. So we need to set at offset 1, which is 12. So this 12 is 9, 10, 11, 12. This is the set. We don't need it. We need offset 2. Offset 2 is directly the 13. So here we need offset 2 plus 1, 2, 3. But we don't know which test came before and if it did make the buffer dirty. So essentially, we should set it as it was. Then here follows root I dot opcode and then we also set most significant byte is uninteresting in this case, so we need to make it an op. So now if bit 2 is set, we still have the same here, but we need the 16-bit address. Next case is 4, which is 0 page indirect, then we could say if the high bit is set, then can, oh, this is offset one, set this to 2, otherwise I actually use offset. Then still must is 8, because here we need 4242EA, because we want this 32-bit mode. Need the EA here because we only have 16 bits. So what do we see? The first part nearly always looks the same. Okay. Just see if it runs open. Issue. Don't have a test on all here. Okay. So the only thing here to do is I only want, I want to overwrite the test result. So essentially I want a line with the test. So we know now we're doing LDQ. And then the tests will just write their result. Of perhaps they don't, yeah, perhaps they don't want to write their result. They only want to write their result if the test fails. So my conk message is the message which goes to the hypervisor. And I only need to do this here if the test fails. And okay. So I only will print a line and advance in the line if something fails. And then I will also write a line after all tests are through, and these should write a sum of failed tests. So I need another number. Failed. Then we said failed client 0 and increment failed if it was failed. And only write the message okay, and then the last message where we again set the name, there we will set test pass failed target size question. If failed, then test fail, else test pass. And we don't need to increment the sub number. The suit issue is used. And we want to write a message and this message is so this is the sub number. Perhaps I also need to add the message number. The issue number, perhaps 02 enough. Also think here 02 is enough. So that's the issue number. This could be 20 long. And then we same here. And the message will be something else. failed. There we use again execute issue. Don't have a fail string. Want failed ones. How much tests did we run? I would say. We have a message. And we subnum is worth. Want then we should be able to do test opcode. Of course. LDQ code. First the suit, then the code. Okay. So does it compile? No, it does not. Right. Undefined simple tests. Ah, okay. I did not finish this part. Yeah. Hey, some brackets missing. One curly bracket is missing. Oh no. Change all the folded stuff. I'm Klein. Ah, der Test. One match. So, compiles. Okay. So, how do we test it? And does it even work? It works. In some way, it should work. So, I don't have the Nexus board running, so let's test it on the XEMU, which will obviously fail, but that's okay. So I could copy it over my disk I normally. This one op test then fire up emu bigger for it's huge, 87 blocks. I can directly run it. Test. Okay, nothing happens. That's interesting. Ah, it's C64 mode. Ah, I always forget. And test. Okay, this looks not good. So, why does it not look good? Should run. Test one of the older. What is go to Mega 64 mode? Before. It was. This one runs. This one does not run. So there is Let's so it does not switch correctly in the right mode. That's but we have, oh, the time is over. I stop the stream now because now my family is calling. So have a nice All Saints Day, and yeah, see you next time. Bye.